was.
Crazy.
I'm calling 911.
Maybe someone already did. I can't talk to the police.
Why not? You didn't do anything wrong.
That's not what it looks like. He ripped my earring out and took it with him when he jumped. I think he was trying to frame me for his murder.
Okay. Well, as screwed up as that is, the best thing you could do is just tell the police what happened.
And if for some miraculous reason they believe me, I'm still screwed. I'm not here legally, Steven. My papers are not valid anymore.
Wait, really? Just get back to the manor before anyone else sees you. You were never here, okay? I'll handle it. Just go.
Excusable. Not to mention disrespectful to all the gays. The whole LTBZ community.
Close enough.
Sir, I didn't know he was Mr. Denard's partner. He didn't mention that
before. Or you weren't listening, because he's gay.
Follow me, and I'll waive visiting hours.
The nurse had already cleaned him
to avoid any possible...
Wait for me? Away from the church? And when he finally reached out again, it was to tell me that it was you that left him rotting in jail.
No, sir, I bailed him out. Look, Ted and I had our ups and downs, just like any other couple, but we were trying to make it work again.
I've been through war.
Much tougher men have tried to lie to me. I know what you're doing. Taking my son's situation and milking the public for sympathy with your little press conference. Will you listen to me? God already knows your sins, but as for me, I will do everything in my power to expose them to the police and to the press. Now get out of my son's room!
Mr. Denard. We have your son's belongings.